guys, what's going on? It's Dog with the Vlog, coming to you guys with a brand new sneaker unboxing. Like I said in my last video, I'm just going to be coming rapid fire with all the stuff that I'm picked up for the holidays and with Christmas money and stuff. So let's get right into it. This is a review of some Air Jordans, as the title says. Before we get into it, no, it's not the Legend Blue 11s. No, it's not the Gifted Flight Pack. This is a different release that kind of just released. This was weird. This was a weird release. This release really was kind of all sorts of screwed up. Here's the box, Jordan box. This was a weird release because these were supposed to come out. Okay, first, before we get into this, I want you guys to make sure if you're into sneakers, you have this app. It's called Unlaced. It's on the App Store. It's free, and it allows you to track all of your releases, sneaker news from Nice Kicks, Kicks on Fire, all the sneaker blogs, and then lets you customize your collection. I don't really customize my collection very much. But I do keep up with releases, and on my Unlaced app, which has never let me down, I knew about the Infrared 6s like in January, so like this app is on point. And so on my Unlaced app, it said that they came out December 20th, the same day as the Legend Blue 11s, and sort of in the craziness of between the Infrared 6s and the Legend Blue 11s and the 13s, these sort of just kind of got lost in the shuffle. It was a 3-pack of shoes. You had the Mellow ones, CP3 ones, and the Blake Griffin ones. I haven't seen the Blake Griffin ones. I've only seen the CP3s and the Mellows. And so it's sort of like a confusing release, like the definition of a quick strike. And then I was in my local mall on Friday the 19th, so the day before the Legend Blues came out, and Foot Locker had the shoes on shelf a day early. Like, they fucked up, so they had the shoes on shelf a day early. I was like, oh, jeez, I went and asked if they had any sizes left. They had, like, one size of the shoe that I got sitting on the shelf, and they were like, oh, well, this is our last size. It's an 8.5. And then the dude starts... Or was that it? Somehow, the dude goes, we only have, like, two sizes left. It's this one and another size. And then he's like, and that guy's trying it on, and, you know, behind him, there's a dude trying them on, like, and I'm like, oh, shit. And then the dude starts, like, talking in this thing. He goes, and we just got a size 10, and I'm like, that's my size. Bring them out. Let me try them on. So I tried them on. I decided to pass on because I only had, like, $150, and I'd have, like, $20 to my name for the next, like, week and a half. So I was like, I'm just going to pass on them, and I'll just live with it. But then, a week and a half later, I'm back in the same Foot Locker, in the same House of Hoops. I was with my friend Melina. We're like, let's just go shut down the mall. We got a bunch of Christmas money, so let's use it. So we're at the mall. And sitting on shelves is this shoe, still on that same size 10. I was like, take it, put it at the front, let's get into it. Jordan box, the remastered Jordan, like 30th anniversary Jordan box. You have this gold Jumpman on the top. You have this Jumpman hit here. You have 25 or 23, 23 right here. And then you have your sizing label. Just by the way, I know that everything's kind of like all the words are backwards in all my videos. It's because I'm filming on my computer camera, so like for whatever reason it flips it. But you also have your sizing label. Air Jordan 1 Retro High, size 10. The sizing label kind of makes it look fake. Like, it kind of looks like a fake Jordan. But these are real, I swear to God. I don't know if these are part of any remastered collection. I don't think so. Because the quality's not bad, but it's not like, wow, this quality's really good. All right, here they are. The Mellow ones. Let me just start by saying, these are so much sicker in person. Holy shit. You know, when I first saw pictures, I was just kind of like, eh, you know, it is what it is. Because the gold in pictures kind of looks like almost like a Dijon mustard, like put it on your sandwich, mustard. But it pops. Like, it's on par with my watch. Like, this shit pops. So let's just jump right into the whole shoe. So you have all over this black nubuck, same as, it's probably about the same quality nubuck as the Infrared 6s, if that's sort of any indicator. Let me tilt this back. If that's any, like, indicator. Then you have, like, a leather gold, which is right here, wraps all the way around. up here, leather on the swoosh, down here on the toe box, and then you have mesh up back here on your tongue, the mellow hit right there on the tongue, black laces, it didn't come with any other colored laces, and then the white outsole, and this is another thing that I didn't actually realize until I saw them, or actually until I got them home, is the bottom is not gold, the bottom is just a gum outsole, and I think that is sick. But, yeah, I mean, there's really nothing to say about, I mean, it's a Jordan 1, it's classic, this is wearable, the black, the gold, you know, you can wear this a lot, I love Jordan 1s, I love the look of them, I love the classicness, so I'm going to be wearing these a ton. In the meantime, I'm going to go ahead and get you guys on feet, and we'll just jump right to that.
First things first, rest in peace, sucker Phil. For real, you the only father that I ever knew. I get my bitch pregnant, I'ma be a better you. Prophecies that I made way back in the veil. For Phil, listen, even back when we was broke, my team ill. Martin Luther King would have been on Dreamville, talk to her, nigga. One time for my LA sisters, one time for my LA hoes. Lame niggas can't tell the difference. One time for a nigga who knows. Don't save her, she don't wanna be saved. Don't save her, she don't wanna be saved. Don't save.
So that about sums up the review. Yeah, like I said, this is just a super sick shoe. And what I love about the shoe is that it just sort of got lost in the mix. Like, no one was camping, no one was hype on the Mellow One. Because everyone was hype on the Jordan Legend Blue 11s. So, you know, the fact that I was able to get these weeks later, you know, I was talking to one of my friends, and he was like saying, like, you know, you only get shoes, like, because you just get fucking lucky. And I was like, yeah, that's totally true. There's no secret to getting shoes. There's no tip. There's just, it's sheer luck. And I've just been super lucky this year with releases. So I hope that continues into 2015. And so thanks for watching. If you guys like this video, go ahead and like, comment, subscribe, tell me what I can improve on. I'm trying to work on the lighting, get that good so you guys can really see the shoe better. But other than that, also, if you guys don't have the app Unlaced, download that. And then follow me on Snups. I don't know if you guys know what Snups is, but it's an app. You just download Snups. That's Snups, S-N-U-P-P-S, on the App Store, and then just go ahead and search Dog with a Vlog, no spaces or underscores or anything, and you'll be able to browse my entire shoe collection by brand. You'll be able to see some of the Vans, that Nike SBs, a lot of the stuff that I didn't do reviews on because I got them before I was doing YouTube, so you guys will kind of get to see the whole collection, and I'll be adding stuff, updating stuff, so I think that's a really cool way for me to be able to keep in touch with you guys. On social media, so I won't ever have to do like any long collection video. My videos are already long enough. And you guys can just keep up with me on Snups. So until next time, I'll see you guys later. Start with the vlog. Peace. Save her, she don't wanna be saved, don't save her. She don't wanna be saved, don't save her. She don't wanna be saved, don't save her. She don't wanna be saved. No role models, and I'm here right now.